Today we're heading out to Mergen, do some shopping. As we wander through the Australian countryside, oh boy, look how dry this is. Mind you, if you live in the UK, you'll probably love this. I think since I returned from India in late March, I think it's only rained 2 days. And now it's September, so now it's September, so I love it. I was raised in the UK, so I hate the weather in the UK. The cold, the snow, the sleet. That's about my memories of the UK. It's terrible. But on a brighter note, I've spent basically the last 40 odd years in the Far East, Australia, and it's always been warm, so I'm not used to the cold. For 40 odd years I've never been in ice or snow or cold. I sometimes wonder about returning to the UK just for a short holiday, but it's also always the weather that frightens me. Anyway, we'll remain on a brighter note, I think, and let's go back to this. I retire in 2 months. on November the 23rd is my final. And I have a plan to do a tour from the base of India, the bottom of India, by a car and drive right up to the house in Assam in northeast India. It's approximately, give or take, a 3,000 kilometer trip. And that's what I've been working on during this COVID thing. What this trip and how I'll do it. And we'll see how that goes, but that trip will probably go on for a couple of months, moving from place to place. So I'll let you know as that one comes into play. But for the time being, this so-called pandemic is a bit of a problem with overseas travel, etc., etc. Anyway, enjoy the view, and let's hope no kangaroos jump out. About a 20 minute trip in, 15-20 minutes. Pretty pretty well can do 100 kilometres an hour all the way. I'm just going to pick up some, a leg of pork. We're going to dinner tonight and we're going to buy a leg of pork and whatever else is required. Probably roast potatoes, a bit like a traditional Christmas dinner, I think. And we're going out to some friend's place. They have a small farm, so we're going out there. At somewhere around 7 o'clock tonight. And this is now the middle of the town. The town's called Mergen. It's in Queensland.
I have to go get some money.
We go again. Yeah. I forget I got a reversing camera. Go 80. as I drive along, I sometimes wonder about my life now, reaching this age of retirement. And I was thinking of all the countries that I'd visited or been to in my life. And I'm not sure I can actually rattle them all off. East Africa, Kenya, Tanzania, Uganda, all through Europe, Belgium, France, Germany, Austria. I've even been to, I was in Bulgaria in the late 70s. that was pretty dramatic. Yugoslavia, Turkey, Iran. I was in Iran in 1979, when in Tehran, in Iran, when the revolution started. Then left there for Afghanistan, Pakistan, India, if you can imagine, Thailand, right through all these Malaysia, all these countries across, and then of course eventuating where I live. My home is in Australia. And over the years I've traveled, I don't know how many times, it's probably 30, 50, I really never kept a detailed log of it. Yeah, it's fairly dramatic. And even I can remember going to Thailand in the late 70s, and there were tanks on the streets, and here we are in 2020 and the tanks are still on the streets, so not a lot's really changed with a lot of countries, really. India's the most progressive one, I think. It just gets on with it. Nothing seems to stop Indians. They just keep on going, which is really good. They're very business orientated, so I think that helps. And the government didn't slip in that stupid communist thing, so they remained a democracy. And for the people who don't know, they have the British democracy and law left by the British, so they had something to follow with the constitution, which is really good. So that's my thoughts for the moment. And tonight we're going to, as I've said before, just a small dinner with some friends. Friend Johnny, for those people out there watching, listening to this, you know who Johnny is. He's been to Assam and to Banaigan in Assam and parts of India. So as soon as these flights are all sorted out and back on, I'm sure he's going to be returning to India. He's only 25, 26 years old, so he's got his whole life ahead of him. Truck. going to reverse in. It's easier to drive out. At least with the reversing camera you can see. If I get it right or not. Actually, I have another little car there. You see that one? That's a Hyundai a Hyundai i30. It's 1.6 litre, 6-speed automatic, air conditioned, power steering, all that rubbish. Okay. Air conditioning off.